Things almost seem like they're back to normal. However, they really aren't. So I recently saw the news and was able to see that our governor here in New York State, Andrew Cuomo, has extended the pause order for New York until June 13th for a reevaluation of the states and regions in the state who have been being hit other than the city by the coronavirus. Since we are being reevaluated here in my county over in Western New York, and we're definitely not open, it's been kind of weird and strange to see there being so much traffic around. I mean, as far as I know, because I've been a little hermit, everything's closed. Here's a video of me driving on the 33. I know I shouldn't have been driving with my phone, but I just wanted to highlight and point out the fact that that was 3 weeks ago when we were at the very beginning or the very middle of our pause order here in New York State, and there was just people willy-nilly driving around. I was out because, unfortunately, I was going to a work meeting. This is how it's been here in our state. I can only imagine how it's been in other places. That was the other thing. The beaches. The beaches are supposed to only be opened by the local government's authority. You already know in Western New York our beaches are about to be open. Byron Brown's not about to keep these things closed. He's got too many fingers in his pockets. Like, I can't imagine that Woodlawn's going to stay closed. And the fact that, you know, Cuomo keeps saying things like, oh, as long as the local governments stay up with the social distancing rules and orders, they can open. Knowing goddamn well, do you live here? Because I live here. And I don't think that that's going to happen, especially in our region here over in Western New York. I just don't. And we just keep raising. We haven't seen a drop in cases at all. So I don't know. It's just kind of mind-boggling to me that this has not been taken care of more. I have an old classmate. Her name is Jess. She lives in England, and she makes it sound scary. She's living in the type of quarantine that I thought America was going to do. They have like an hour a day. She was saying on our last day of class, she was saying that they were allowed to go out a little bit more now, you know, just to be able to walk their animals a little bit extra. And it's not anything close to what we've done. And I've seen some reports from the news saying that we're now the highest country in the world to have these cases and that we're not going back anytime soon. You know, we're always so afraid of martial law and the New World Order and all these things. We're afraid of the government coming, always. But it almost seems like the government never comes when we actually need them to come. They're always coming during some time when we don't need the government to come. We don't need the military during a earthquake. We need the military during a pandemic. Like, I just don't understand what's going on here. And we all really, like, it's almost like people are going back to normal by force. I saw something earlier on Facebook and it said something like, shh, don't acknowledge the coronavirus. We don't talk. It was something like along the lines of Fight Club and how we don't talk about Fight Club and how we don't talk about coronavirus because we are trying to get back to Walmart. And it was fucking hilarious. I literally laughed out loud, which I don't often do, but it was fucking funny. I do have some video and pictures of some of the grocery stores before we started to go on pause in New York. I was able to get some of those things by filming it myself and asking some friends and family members for their pictures that they have taken at the grocery store, like when they were going and seeing the complete chaos and there being completely no toilet paper. So I wanted to talk to you guys about the fact that our food prices are now rising. CNN reported that American grocery store prices have risen about 2.6% just in April, and we're just in the first couple of weeks of May. It's the biggest price jump since 1974. Now, 1974, all of my aunties and cousins were little kids. That's a long-ass time, because they almost all 44 and up. CNN also reported that the food supply chain has been disrupted by the pandemic. Some restaurants have also had to shut down. There was a big article on how Wendy's has actually run out of burgers and meat products for a lot of their restaurants and have had to take some burgers off of their menus for some restaurants in the country. That's crazy. Places like Burger King, McDonald's, and Wendy's aren't able to get meat and food. That's impossible. I would never have thought that that would have ever happened before. So these things all started happening basically because of the panic buying and all of that that happened 2 months ago. Because we had a lot of panic buying, because we had a lot of people hoarding food products, meat products, beef, chicken, pork, those types of things, now we're going to be completely asked out. Basically, the long story short is a high demand for food, but low supply is going to equal higher prices. It all kind of just seems like a mess to me because I'm just seeing now that a lot of people are still just now getting their unemployment for the first time in this state. I'm not sure about other places, but this state, people are still just now getting their unemployment. And with food and prices and things, necessities going up and getting higher at the level of pay that people were getting before, because a lot of people weren't making that much money, we're going to end up being in for the time of our lives in a couple of years. Like, just by 2022, it's going to be a whole different place. At least that's what I feel. That's what I believe. And again, like I said, we haven't had a price raise in our food like this since 1974. That's a really long time. I don't know what we're going to do. And I hope we're able to fix it up. Thank you for watching this week's episode of Pandemic Americana. If you would like to be a person I interview, please give me a shout out on social media like Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter, or you can send me an email with your interest at Prenelle Flamel, PRENELLE FLAMEL, @gmail.com. And I will get back to you as soon as possible with dates and times for us to do an interview. Again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys with another episode very soon. Cheers.